So this will be the machine we'll be using for the experiment.
Now I'm currently turning on the power and waiting for the machine to start properly. It doesn't really need a warm-up time, and it actually starts up pretty fast. It's time to insert the column into the instrument, and this is how the column looks like. It goes there at the bottom, as you could kind of see, and then the top will get connected to the lever. The instrument will auto recognize what kind of column you have there at the top. Now it is time to choose a method of which how it would load. We will be going with the gold speed and see what happens from there. We will be using solvent A as hexane, and right next to it, solvent B is ethyl acetate, and we'll be able to type in a name as a sample name, which would allow us to save and record the sample when the experiment is finished. Run a gradient purification. The blue is percent B or percent ethyl acetate. The blue line will start off at zero and will increase to 100% ethyl acetate and hold at 100% for a couple minutes, which should theoretically give us a good separation. Go ahead and press start. Menu of which rack to start. We have the left and the right one. We will begin on the left rack on the first tube, which is right there. For the sample, we will press liquid load and allow for an end of run hold to decide if and when the column is complete. And then we will be able to press OK. Process is beginning, which is called equilibrating, where the solvent goes through the pumps into the column to get the silica gel wet. We are ready to inject our sample, which would require a syringe. Typically, the needle is on the syringe so that it's easy to withdraw from our sample. And the sample is usually in a vial, so you can easily get all of it. We're about to withdraw our sample into the syringe.
At this point, we're just making sure we get all the drops from the syringe and ensuring that there's no air bubbles in there so we could load our sample in properly.
We need to remove the needle from the syringe since it's not necessary to load it into the column. It'll go in the properly labeled waste bucket. Next thing we're going to do is open the upper arm, which will allow the column to stay upright. We'll connect the syringe and slowly add the contents. You shouldn't really push too hard, and it could take a couple seconds, maybe up to like 30 seconds. Now you'd be able to see that the column is loaded. You could remove the syringe, reconnect the upper arm, and dispose of the syringe into the properly labeled waste container. To start, we are able to press OK that shows up on the screen. You see the solution going into the test tube, and when it's full, it actually moves on to the next test tube, and it does so in a sequential fashion. When the solution goes through the apparatus, it goes through a UV detector. On the left, we'll give the UV readout of the live eluate. When a peak is detected, it will automatically move to another tube in order to get the best peak-to-peak resolution, as you see right there. There seems to be a small peak happening around 4. It's going to be a 2x speed of how the machine looks like while it is conducting the experiment. Close-up of the monitor and the apparatus which is performing the separation. It would give you a readout and a map of the tubes that the instrument believes contains various compounds on the right and the left. It also color codes the tubes depending on how similar it believes the solutions are. So it's saying 4 is different from 11, and 12 and 13 are different from those, and 14 through 21 would all be pretty similar and different from tube 4. Now it's time to verify if these tubes contain different compounds, which is usually done by TLC. Option to extend the run if we would like. If you have a lot of peaks towards the end, it's actually recommended. But for us, since we have a nice flat baseline, it means most likely all of our mixture has eluted. Click the separation complete button, and it will allow the system to do a wash and an air purge. It's up to us to determine the success of our column. We will verify the different compounds using a TLC method. We're only loading tubes 11 through 18, mostly because 18 and on, they're pretty similar, and 4's peak was actually a little too small for it to be anything really considerable. We will be testing the TLC strip under UV light because not all of it is visible to the naked eye, and this will just help us visualize the separation that has happened. A marked visual of the separation that has happened. You are able to enter your flash drive and save it as a PDF or any other format that you would like. So now we'll be inserting tubes 14 through 17 since they had very similar separation using the instrument as well as using the TLC method. We'll put into a round bottom flask and into the rotovap in order to remove the solvents that were used in the experiment. This will be a quick video of the rotovap working. It's been set up and we'll come back to see the finished product. This is the collected product using column chromatography.